Hello guys, this is Navin Reddy. In this video, we'll talk about how to take input from user using system.out or system.in.read method. Now, if we talk about user input in Java, we can use a class called a scanner, or we can use something called as buffer reader. Okay, so these are the two ways you can using which you can take input from user. So you can create either scanner object or you can use buffer reader object. But hold on, you know, if you want to print something in Java, we simply say system. We use this statement, right? We use system.out.println to print something, which simply means this println is a method which belongs to an object called as out. So out here is the object of printStream class, and the object is created in system class. So this is the standard way of printing something, right? And if you have the same thing in C programming, it will be printf. So in C programming we use printf, and then in C++ we use cout, and then in C# we use console.writeline. So if you can observe, in every programming we have some or the other way to print this, to print anything, right? Now what about user input? So for user input, what we need is these two class, right? But in C programming, for user input, we have scanf. So we can directly use scanf to take user input. In C++, the thing is cin. And in C#, we use something called as console.readline. So what's more important here is we have direct method to take, to print something and to take input. But in Java, we need to use scanner and buffer reader. Don't we have any other way of doing it? And of course we have. Like we have in all this programming, we have some of the other way to take input. So in Java also, we have the standard way to take input, which is system. So sensibly, to print, we use out, right? And to take input, we use something called as in, because we are taking input. And then we need a method to read the value. So to print, we have println, or we can simply say print. And to read, we have something called as read. So there's a method called as read. And if you use read, it will give you the input. Okay. So to print something, we have print. And to read something, we have read. Now let's try to see how this read method works. Let me remove all this and let's start with a concept. Now, for sure, whenever you say read, it might throw an error. So what we'll do is we'll say throws exception here, so that we can focus on the code. And let me use system. It's system.in.read. And if you see the signature of read, so let me just go to this read method. And if you see the signature, it says it's an abstract method, which throws an IO exception, and it reads next byte of the data from the input stream. Okay, and then it will return the value from 0 to 255. Okay, that means if whenever you use read, it can only take a range of 0 to 255. Okay, that means I have to store somewhere, we have to store into a byte value, but still we'll use an int value. Let's see how it works. So we'll say int I equal to system.in.read, and let's try to print the value of I. Let's see what happens. So if I enter a value, let's say 5. So let's run this. So Shift F6. Okay, it's waiting for my input. I will simply say 5. So what I'm doing here is I'm taking the value and storing it in I and then printing the value of I. So the output should also be 5, right? But when I say enter, the output is very different. So if 53, where this 3 is coming from? Let's take a new value. So let me run this again. This time I will give 0. Okay, it says 48. And now if you observe this, don't you think it's look like ASCII value of 0? Because the ASCII value of 0 is 48 and the ASCII value of 5 is 53. That means it's taking the value as a character, which it converts into an int value, which is ASCII value, and then it's printing it. So let me prove my point. If I say, if I run this, and if I give A as input, the output will be 65. So what it's doing is it's taking the input as the ASCII value and then converting into the, the ASCII value, from character to ASCII value. But let's say I want to print the character itself. So what we can do is we can again convert that integer into character using char casting here. So we can use typecast to print the value. And now if you run this, it's waiting for the input. Let's say A, it will print A because we are converting that into a character type. But what if I need to take the whole string as the input? Because see, when you say read, it will take only one character. What I want to take the whole string. And that's the biggest drawback of this read. Read can only take one character at a time. Okay, so unlike C programming, we can take the whole line. In fact, in C++ also, we can take the whole line. But the default method of n, which is read, takes only one character. So in this scenario, what we can do is we can, if you want to hold string, we can simply say a string str. The default value will be blank, and then we can apply a loop here. And what loop will check is, let's say system.in.read. Now this value should not be equal to, enter. Okay, so we can check enter also here. In fact, I don't know the ASCII value for enter, so what we'll do is we'll just run this code just to get the ASCII value of enter. So we'll say shift F6, enter, okay, it's enter, it's not printing. So what we can do is we can check, we can run a loop which will check for the input as, let's say, as soon as I enter 0, we'll do this thing, we'll say while system.in.read it's not equal to 48, by the time it will take the input and then it will store that value in str. So what we'll do is we'll say int I equal to this value. Okay. Okay. So we'll say int I equal to value and I plus, or we'll say str plus I. Okay. So if I run this, but it will concatenate all the numbers. I want to concatenate the string, so we can simply cast it with the character. And now if you run this. Okay, and then we'll print the value of str itself. So we'll say bracket and str. Let's save this. And now if you run, it's waiting for the input. I will say it's Naveen Reddy, enter. Oh, it's printing. What's the issue now? Okay. Let me run this again. So it's Naveen Reddy 0. So you can see it's printing my name in this format. Hey guys, let's run this again. 0. Enter. So you can see it's printing in this way. Now, what's the better way of doing this is, instead of using this system.in.read, which only gives the integer value, what you can do is you can just use the advanced classes. One of the advanced classes is scanner, and the advanced classes is buffer reader. So what this do is, these two things, they actually use system.in.read as a method to take the input, and they just enhance the user experience using these classes. So we have multiple ways to take input. So one of the basic way is system.in.read, and we can also use scanner and buffer reader. So that's the concept about read method in object.